Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to use a Photoshop Smart Object mockup to put a kind of faux vinyl decal on a car window. Okay, let's get started. So when you buy a mockup like this with a Photoshop Smart Object, which is right here, you have to own Photoshop to be able to use that. So usually a designer will also just include a blank photo, just so if you don't have Photoshop, you can still drop your transparent PNG decal image on it and resize it, and then you're good to go. I'll also be doing another video soon of how to do this in Canva, which is free with an account, but an account is also free. The main difference between using a Photoshop Smart Object is that it will cause your decal to wrap around a curved object, and you can see that it matches the window and the way it curves around, which is pretty cool. I'm going to go ahead and just close this so you can see how to get it into Photoshop and everything you need to do. Now, normally when you download something, it's going to go into your download folder. So that'll usually be over here if you're on a PC, or you can get there by hitting Option Command L on a Mac. The file that we want is the one that ends in PSD. So I'm going to double click this and it'll open in Photoshop. And now I need to open my Layers panel. So to do that, I'll come up here to Window, Layers. And you can see the Smart Object right here. You can tell it's a Smart Object because it has this little page right down here in the bottom right corner. So to use the Smart Object, all we have to do is double click it. When we do that, we get a brand new window with a different kind of file. This one ends in PSB. And here's the old decal that we want to replace. So let's go ahead and grab our decal that we want to put into this file. I'll come out here to the Finder and navigate to the decal I want. And I'm just going to click this and drag it into the Photoshop file. And then I can hold Option or Alt on a PC and bring in the corner. You might have to hold Shift also in order to size it proportionally. And that'll depend on what version of Photoshop you have. So I want it to be just about the size of that other one that's in there. I'm going to release and then hit enter or return. And now we can click on the layer where our old decal was and just pull it to our trash can. So now we just have our new decal. The thing is, if we click back on our other file, you can see that it's white, a white image on a dark background. So we need to make our new decal white also. So I'll come down here to FX. And then I'll choose Color Overlay. Make sure you're clicked on it, and then you'll see the color right here. We'll just click on that and make sure you go all the way up to the corner and past the corner a little bit to get true white. Then we'll say OK. And we can say OK again. Now our image is white, and this is exactly what we want. So now we can save with Command S or Control S, and we'll just X out of this PSB file. And now it's updated in the mockup itself. So this is perfect. This is exactly what we want. Now you probably only want to use maybe this much. We can crop the image by hitting C on our keyboard. That'll bring up these crop areas. We'll come up here to the top bar and hit clear. And then we can just pull this in and crop it any way we like. And then we'll hit enter or return to kind of save the changes. And now we can save this as a JPEG or PNG to use as a marketing image on Instagram or Facebook or any site you want to save it on. So we'll go to File, Export, and Export As. And here you can change the size. Maybe you don't want it this big. You just put it to 400 or something like that, and then hit Tab to get down to the next section. We can choose PNG or JPEG here. I would choose one of these. These other ones, I would leave those alone, but JPEG is a good option for this. We'll export, and then you can just save it as your file wherever you want. If you're having trouble of any kind, you can leave that in the comment section below. I'll do my best to answer all your questions. All right, if you like this video, please click on the like button, and I'll see you next week with another SVG Cut File tutorial. Thank you.